टेस्ट कर लिया ना?
Distinguished members, my senior officers, and all the viewers, a very good morning to all of you. It is indeed a great honor for me to address this gathering about the SARAS, School Affiliation Re-engineered Automation System, which places a lot of reliance on technology, artificial intelligence, data-driven, which makes the affiliation process easy, accessible, and responsive to ground realities. In tune with National Education Policy 2020, CBSE endeavors to make the affiliation process with accuracy, prompt with least wastage, and result-oriented outcomes. Most of the processes involved are on the basis of self-disclosure, with an aim to empower the schools and teachers with trust and enable them to strive for excellence and perform their best, thereby prepare the students for a technology-enabled future. Now I would request Chairman CBSE to give the introduction. Shri Manoj Ahuja, IAS officer, I would request you to address the gathering, sir.
Thank you, Dharni. All the principals, owners, managers, and representatives from schools across the country, both from schools which are already members of the CBSE family and those from schools which wish to become members of the CBSE family. On behalf of my team present here, I wish you a very good morning and hope that this webinar, which is perhaps the first of its kind, will be very useful for you. All of us have heard about the term ease of doing business. The government has time and again stated that we should ensure that any transaction which we have with stakeholders should be easy and result oriented. And therefore, the term ease of doing business. All of you must have heard about the National Education Policy which came out in 2020. Dharni has alluded to that. It talks about a light but tight regulatory framework. What does this term imply? Essentially, when CBSE affiliates schools, we have as presently 25,000 schools affiliated to us, and the number is expanding every year. Our objective is, while we are affiliating schools, that the schools should meet certain minimum standards. Certain minimum infrastructure standards, certain minimum academic standards, so that quality education can be provided. And with that purpose, we carry out a purpose of the process of affiliation. Those schools who have been associated with us earlier would know that CBSE over the years has been taking a number of steps to simplify the affiliation process, and this new re-engineering is also a step in that direction. First of all, I would like to convey that for new schools or any school which is applying for upgradation or switchover, which is coming in contact with CBSE for the first time, we will ensure that the application is cleared within 4 months, which is a big step in terms of decreasing the time for such applications. Regarding old applications, we will, based on data analytics and all, clear applications except for a select few which will go for inspections. We have tried to integrate technology with the whole process. So for example, you will be now putting in data on basis of self-certification. Those self-certified certificates will also be read through machine learning and AI. We are also relying heavily in terms of public disclosure. The facts which you are giving to us in terms of mandatory certificates would be available on CBSE website and would also be available on your website. We feel that there should be transparency in terms of information which the schools are giving us for seeking affiliation, and transparency in terms of the transactions we have with you. We have taken some steps to ensure that whatever decision is taken by us, whatever stage the file is pending is also available with these schools. So any certification, any communication to you would be available through on a click of a button. It will not be through emails or not be through SMSs, so that you know what is the status of the application. Essentially, what this process requires is that you should have certain mandatory certificates which you would be uploading. It will be machine read, and then directly, if you meet the certain criteria for new schools or a certain segment of schools, an inspection committee will be constituted. We have ensured that people doing inspections are selected carefully, they know their mandate, and they do their job professionally. We have given very strict timelines and also given the chance for schools to give feedback on what the inspection committee has suggested. All in all, we have looked at all the aspects, right from the first stage till the end, to ensure that communication is two-way, it is transparent, and it is accountable. Accountable for both, for the schools to give us correct information, and for us to deal with that application in a professional and transparent and a time-bound manner. This is a system. We expect there will be new teething troubles when we actually implement it. Therefore, we look at you as our users to give us constant feedback on the system, so that whatever small errors or mistakes would remain in the system, we would like to correct them. So essentially, for us, it's trying to address some of the issues you had raised in terms of making it time bound, with dedicated timelines, ensuring transparency and accountability, making use of technology, and essentially ensuring that all our stakeholders who interact with us are able to do so in a very professional and fulfilling manner. Our primary objective, as I said, is to ensure that schools who have the minimum standards and fulfill them get affiliation in as less time as possible, and we are committed to that endeavor. Me and my team are committed to that endeavor, and as I said, we are very open to feedback now after the session, and immediately when we implement this from March 16, we look forward to your feedback and a constant engagement to ensure that the services we deliver to our people are state of the art and the best in the country and globally. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. Now may I request Secretary CBSE to brief the gathering about the various categories of affiliation and requirements of document in the new system. Sir, over to you.
Namaskar. Entire affiliation process ko three groups mein divide kiya gaya hai. Group A, Group B and Group C. Further, in three groups ko 15 categories mein divide kiya gaya hai. Group A mein 7 categories, Group B mein 5 categories and Group C mein 3 categories aati hai. Group A mein jo 7 categories hain, unmein fresh affiliation middle level, fresh affiliation secondary level, fresh affiliation senior secondary level, switchover category secondary level, switchover category senior secondary level, side shifting and restoration of affiliation. Ye 7 categories hain jinko group A mein rakha gaya hai. Group B mein 5 categories aati hain jinmein upgradation secondary level, upgradation senior secondary level, extension, permission for two shifts and section increase. Group B mein in 5 categories ko rakha gaya hai. Teesri category group C mein total 3 categories aati hain: additional subjects, name change of school and society, and third transfer of school / change of society. Jo group A category hai jinmein 7 categories ko main fir repeat karunga: fresh affiliation middle, secondary, senior secondary, switchover secondary, senior secondary, side shifting and restoration of affiliation. Unmein jo required document hai wo main aapko batana ja raha hu. Group A ki in 7 categories ke liye aapko state government ki NOC ki zarurat hogi, recognition certificate ki zarurat hogi, land certificate ki zarurat hogi, fire safety, building safety ki zarurat hogi, society compactness ki zarurat hogi, trust registration ki zarurat hogi, aur system generated self certified by principal and manager iski zarurat hogi. Iske alawa agar self certification pe aap nahi aana chahte to system generated DO certificate signed by DO ki avashyakta hogi. Ye 7 categories ke liye in documents ki compulsory way mein avashyakta hai. ग्रुप बी जिनमें 5 कैटेगरी जाती हैं, अपग्रेडेशन, सेकेंडरी, सीनियर सेकेंडरी, एक्सटेंशन, परमिशन फॉर साइट शिफ्टिंग एंड सेक्शन इंक्रीज, इनके लिए जो आपको डॉक्यूमेंट्स की जरूरत होगी वो मैं आपको बताने जा रहा हूं। अपग्रेडेशन के लिए आपको बिल्डिंग सेफ्टी सर्टिफिकेट की जरूरत होगी, फायर सेफ्टी सर्टिफिकेट, डिटेल्स ऑफ एडिशनल क्लासरूम्स, कंपोजिट साइंस लैब, जीपीएस इनेबल्ड फोटो एंड वीडियोज ऑफ साइंस लैब एंड सिस्टम जनरेटेड सेल्फ सर्टिफिकेशन साइंड बाय प्रिंसिपल एंड मैनेजर। अपग्रेडेशन टू सीनियर सेकेंडरी के लिए ऊपर के जो डॉक्यूमेंट आपको बताए गए हैं उनके अलावा साइंस लैब की फोटो एंड वीडियोज जीपीएस एनेबल्ड की आवश्यकता होगी। एक्सटेंशन के लिए जो सर्टिफिकेट की जरूरत होगी उनमें बिल्डिंग सेफ्टी की जरूरत होगी, फायर सेफ्टी की जरूरत होगी, सिस्टम जनरेटेड सेल्फ सर्टिफिकेट साइंड बाय प्रिंसिपल एंड मैनेजर की आवश्यकता होगी। परमिशन फॉर टू शिफ्ट्स, इनके लिए आपको फायर सेफ्टी की, बिल्डिंग सेफ्टी की, टीचर डिटेल्स फॉर सेकेंड शिफ्ट की, परमिशन फ्रॉम स्टेट गवर्नमेंट फॉर साइट शिफ्टिंग की एंड सिस्टम जनरेटेड सेल्फ सर्टिफिकेट की आवश्यकता होगी। ग्रुप बी की जो 5वीं कैटेगरी है सेक्शन इंक्रीज, उसके लिए फायर सेफ्टी की, बिल्डिंग सेफ्टी की, एडिशनल रूम की डिटेल की, एडिशनल टीचर्स डिटेल की एंड सिस्टम जनरेटेड सेल्फ सर्टिफिकेशन की आवश्यकता होगी। ग्रुप सी कैटेगरी में जो हमारी 3 कैटेगरीज आती हैं, एडिशनल सब्जेक्ट, नेम चेंज ऑफ स्कूल एंड सोसाइटी एंड ट्रांसफर ऑफ सोसाइटी, उनमें जिन डॉक्यूमेंट्स की जरूरत होगी वो मैं आपको बताने जा रहा हूँ। एडिशनल सब्जेक्ट के लिए डिटेल ऑफ एडिशनल रूम्स, साइंस लैब्स एंड जीपीएस इनेबल्ड फोटोज एंड वीडियोज और सिस्टम जनरेटेड सेल्फ सर्टिफिकेट की आवश्यकता होगी। जो नेम चेंज एंड सोसाइटी चेंज है उसके लिए स्टेट गवर्नमेंट की परमिशन एंड सिस्टम जनरेटेड सेल्फ सर्टिफिकेट की आवश्यकता होगी। तीसरी कैटेगरी जो ट्रांसफर ऑफ सोसाइटी ऑब्लिक चेंज ऑफ सोसाइटी है उसमें स्टेट गवर्नमेंट की परमिशन की आवश्यकता होगी और सिस्टम जनरेटेड सेल्फ सर्टिफिकेशन की आवश्यकता होगी। जैसा कि आपने सुना और समझा, जो ग्रुप ए कैटेगरी है उसमें आपको मैक्सिमम सर्टिफिकेट की जरूरत है, ग्रुप बी में उससे कम और ग्रुप सी कैटेगरी में उससे भी कम सर्टिफिकेट्स की आवश्यकता होगी। इस पूरी प्रोसेस को जिसमें डॉक्यूमेंट्स और कैटेगरीज हैं उनको और डिटेल में हम आपको समझाने के लिए एक वीडियो प्ले करना चाह रहे हैं जिसके द्वारा आप डिटेल में समझ सकेंगे कैटेगरीज के बारे में और डॉक्यूमेंट्स के बारे में।
दिस मॉड्यूल इज इन कॉन्टिन्यूएशन टू द डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ स्कूल्स अप्लाइंग फॉर अफिलिएशन अंडर सीबीएसई। इट हाइलाइट्स द डॉक्यूमेंट्स दैट वुड बी रिक्वायर्ड फॉर द अफिलिएशन विद सीबीएसई अंडर डिफरेंट हेड्स। The documents required for affiliation with the CBSE under various categories. The category for affiliation related applications, that is approval for middle school syllabus, fresh affiliation up to secondary level switchover from other boards, fresh affiliation up to senior secondary level switchover from other boards, permission of site shifting or restoration of affiliation. These categories shall give the following mandatory documents to be uploaded in Part A of the form. Admission certificate issued by the appropriate government authority. Recognition certificate issued by the appropriate government authority. Registration certificate of the society or registered trust deed of the trust, certificate of incorporation of the company running the school, land certificate as per Appendix 10 of affiliation bylaws certifying the compactness of the plot or campus area, fire safety certificate issued by the competent authority, building safety certificate issued by the competent authority, self-certification signed by the principal or manager of the school, or system-generated certificates signed by district education administration. The category upgradation of secondary level related applications need to submit the mandatory documents. Fire safety certificate issued by competent authority, building safety certificate issued by the competent authority, Details of additional rooms for secondary classes and composite science lab. Composite science lab, GPS enabled photo and video. Self-certification signed by the principal or manager of the school or system generated DEO certificate. The category upgradation of senior secondary level shall submit the following mandatory documents: fire safety certificate issued by the competent authority, building safety certificate issued by the competent authority, details of additional rooms for senior secondary classes and science subjects labs in case of with science subjects category, GPS enabled photos and videos to be given in case of science, self-certification issued by the principal or manager of the school or system generated DEO certificate. The category extension of affiliation. The following documents need to be submitted: fire safety certificate issued by the competent authority, building safety certificate issued by the competent authority, self-certification signed by principal or manager of the school, or a system generated certificate signed by district education administration. The school seeking permission of two shifts shall need to give the following documents: fire safety certificate issued by the competent authority, building safety certificate issued by the competent authority, teachers' details for second shift, permission for appropriate state, government authority for running school in two shifts, self-certification signed by principal or manager of the school, or a system generated certificate signed by the district education administration. The school seeking affiliation for section increase. The documents required are fire safety certificate issued by the competent authority, building safety certificate issued by the competent authority, additional rooms details, self-certification signed by principal or manager of the school. For school seeking introduction of additional subject, the following documents are required: details of additional rooms for senior secondary classes and science subjects labs, science subjects labs GPS enabled photos and videos, self-certification signed by the principal manager of the school. Schools seeking permission of name change of school society as per status of the school. The documents required are permission from appropriate state government authority for name change, self-certification signed by principal or manager of the school, the transfer of school from one society to another, permission from appropriate state government authority from transfer of school, self-certification signed by principal or manager of the school or assistant. Documents required for foreign schools: NOC or letter to this effect issued by High Commission, Consulate, Embassy of India. License or permission for school issued by the concerned government. A system generated certificate signed by the principal and manager of the school, or system generated certificate signed by High Commission, Consulate or the Embassy of India. The school seeking regular affiliation. The documents required are establishment letter issued by the appropriate authority, that is Kendriya Vidyalaya Sangathan, Navodaya Vidyalaya Samiti, Directorate of Education, Education Department or authorized signatory. Approval letter issued by appropriate government authority, fire safety certificate issued by the competent authority, building safety certificate issued by the competent authority, system generated certificate signed by the principal of the school, or a system generated certificate signed by competent authority running the school, that is Kendriya Vidyalaya Sangathan, Navodaya Vidyalaya Samiti, Directorate of Education, Education Department, or the authorized signatory. Additional points to be noted. Number one, no other institution apart from school is allowed to run or operate in the claimed land area of the school. Point two, no public road, canal, or thoroughfare, high tension line, etc., to be passed through the land of the school. Number three, no classes of 9th, 10th, 11th, or 12th under CBSE pattern to be run without obtaining permission or affiliation of the board. Thank you.
May I request Director IT to address the gathering? This, sir, the floor is all yours. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Once again, greetings to all those who are attending this webcast today. Chairman sir has already given you the insight of this newly restructured and re-engineered affiliation system. You know, the CBSE started a digital journey of affiliation system in way back in 1991, and now we have, our systems are so matured that we can now think of putting the entire technology driven system where we can make use of the artificial intelligence, machine learning, data analytics, GIS and all. As you have already, the previous speaker has told you about the category of the various affiliation and also the documents required. I would like to tell you the process of the entire application, how it will start and how it will end. Now, there are two categories of school mainly. One is the government schools, one is the independent schools. And both these schools are situated in India as well as abroad, because we have got certain Kendriya Vidyalayas which are situated abroad, like in Nepal, in Russia, and Iran and all. And then we have got independent schools which are spread all over India and abroad. But the entire application process has been divided into three main segments. One segment is for the independent schools, one segment for the government schools, one segment for the foreign schools. In the independent category of schools, again, there are two types of schools. One will be for the first time applying for the any kind of the category of affiliation with the board. Second, those who are already affiliated with the board and will be applying for a category falling into the existing category schools, like for example, upgradation, sections, grease and all. Similarly, in the government setup also, there will be certain schools which will be newly adding to the CBSE family, and there will be certain schools who are already affiliated to the board and will be seeking the permission for upgradation or for addition subject like that. Same way for the foreign schools. Now, first I will tell you about the entire application process of the new schools in the independent category, in the government, as well as in the foreign categories. The entire application process has been very, very simplified, because you know, we have got now, Chairman sir has already told you, but the CBSE focus is on now stakeholder centric and the ease of doing and ease of living, and with the minimum possible documentation and all. So we are starting with the first process of the KYC. All such schools who want to be the part of the CBSE for the first time, maybe in India, maybe government setup, maybe the foreign schools, will have to apply in this category. First, they have to select the category of the school and then fill in the KYC performa. After filling the KYC performa, then they will have to make the registration payment of the registration fees, which is the 10,000. Now, this 10,000 fees is common to all categories, maybe in the independent schools, maybe the government school, maybe the foreign school. After this payment, there will be a party of the form, which is very, very important. where you will be taking the mandatory information from the all schools, and there will be mandatory document upload, which was just not told you in the last video. So all these schools, they will be filling the part A of the form. In the part A of the form, after filling the data, then there will be a self certificate will be generated based on the data submitted by the school. The same self certificate, along with some other documents which were told to you by the earlier speaker, that NOC, registration and whatever, those documents which are of that category required as a mandatory document are to be uploaded. So once the KYC over, then payment, then part A. After part A, the mandatory documents will be uploaded. Once these steps are done, you will be prompted for filling the part B of the form. Now part B of the form is a little detailed one, but not that much detail which you were filling earlier. So you will be filling the part B of the form, where you will be giving about your infrastructure, where you will be telling something about your faculty, where you will be telling something about your students' strength, area, facilities, labs, rooms, and so on and so forth. After filling the part B of the form, again you will have to make the payment of the fees. Now this fee will be the fee for the affiliation minus the 10,000 which you paid at the after the KYC stage. Okay, so that KYC payment, the registration payment will be adjusted here. So no extra fees is being charged. It is the same fees which is was earlier, only it is being taken in two parts. The reason how we are, why we are taking two part, because there may be certain schools who after the KYC are not having a particular document ready with them, a particular information ready with them. So they can wait for filling the rest of the form. They can wait at that stage, and once they have that particular document, then they can apply and then fill the part B of the form. Once the part B of the form is filled, then schools will be requested to finalize the data submitted by them. After you finalize the data, then again, after taking the part B payment, then there will be process of inspection for the new schools in case of the independent schools only. For the government schools and for the foreign schools, there will not be any inspection process. Based on the data submitted by them, based on the certification submitted by them, based on the mandatory documents submitted by them, which will be all will be machine read, on that basis, their process of affiliation will move further. However, for all other independent schools, there will be a process of inspection. Now, for the inspection process, we have again given the power in the hand of the school itself. Just on a click of a button, they will be able to know what is the, who are the members of the inspection committee. And that inspection committee will be taken from the data bank of inspecting members of the board. There will be a group of good principals, some academicians and all. And then from that, they will be selecting the two members will be shown to them as the inspection committee members. After the inspection committee is selected, then they can select the date of the inspection also. There, that also we have given. Now all this you will find is given in a progress panel. When you will be filling the form, you will find on the left side there is a, there are certain icons given, and there is, it is given the progress panel. After clicking progress panel, you can also find out where, at what stage your application has gone, what all processes you have completed. And also while you will be filling the data, there will be a progress bar on the top of the screen. It will show how much data you have filled up, which particular part you have filled up. So all time you will be able to see what all you have completed, steps you have completed, and also you will be able to see on the progress panel up to which stage your application is gone. Now once the inspection date is finalized, then inspection will be conducted by the inspection committee members, and after inspection is over, then we will be requesting schools which have been inspected to submit their feedback about the entire process of inspection. The moment you will complete the feedback, the report of the inspection committee will be visible to the schools. They will be able to see what school what the inspection committee has observed, what best practices, good practices, what are the some suggestions of improvement the committee has given, and then we'll further request schools to submit a comment on that if they want to submit. Okay, once this is done, then there'll be a process which will be very quick process, and the after the completion of the process, there will be a decision given to the school whether it has been granted or the school has not been found eligible for the grant. In case of the grant, then the school will be able to further fill up the Part C of the form of the application or affiliation form, and then can generate their grant letter at their own. In case of if they find if the decision is not found eligible for the grant, then there will be a review committee, and the entire process, entire affiliation, the inspection process will be done by the review committee. Okay, there will be a review committee. Review committee will review the decision of the inspection committee and also take the cognizance of the comments submitted by the school. And then this is the first time it has been introduced. The review committee system has been introduced, and if review committee finds yes, a school is suitable for the grant, then there will be a decision of the review committee. So once the once you know the decision, then thereafter you can generate the letter from the progress panel itself. Now this is the case of the new schools, but for the existing schools, there is absolutely very very simple steps. Only those schools have to simply fill up the part of the form. That's it. No KYC, because you are already part of our system. So we are not asking you to fill up any KYC. You have to simply fill the part A, part B of the form, part C of the form will be pre-populated from the data you have already submitted in OSS. Because now in the new system which is coming up, we are having the total dependency on the OSS data which you are submitting every year. And we are sure that you are updating your OSS data every year, because this is going to be the single source of the truthful data. Now with this data only, based on this data, based on the performance and the, of the result in last 5 years, 3 years, whatever, for how long the school is associated with the board, we also every year giving the letter of different violations done by the school, based on the OSS data analytics, based on the performance in the previous results and the violations done, there'll be a automatic grant system. Okay, so in that case the process will be very quick. Same way for the government and the foreign, there will not be an inspection. After KYC, part A, part B, there'll be a immediate issue of the grant letter for the foreign government school as well as foreign school. So the entire process, as I told you, is now divided into two major processes. One is where the from KYC to the grant system is there, where you have to fill forms and all, and also inspection to be conducted. In other segment, there will be only part A to be filled up. Rest every data will be taken from your OSS data, and you have to simply make payment and the. So now in this case, you know that there was a existing schools of independent, government schools, new government school independent, foreign schools new, foreign school independent, will be passing through without any inspection, and the grant will be there, grant decision will be there. It will be same day, maybe in a day or two, but not beyond a week's time, it will be done. Because it will be subject to the realization of the payment submitted by the schools. So this is the way the entire process flow will be there, application will, and the timeline for all foreign schools will be at least 10 working days minimum. The reason being, because the payment submitted by the foreign banks, normally the transfer takes up to 10 working days. So after 10 working days, they can generate their letter of decision, grant letter. And for all Indian schools, it will be at least 2 to 5 days time for existing schools. However, for the independent schools which are going through inspection process, or independent existing schools which are going through inspection process, will have to wait till their inspection is over, but under no circumstances it will be beyond 4 months time. which is the commitment of the board. So the entire process will be completed in the maximum 4 months time, which otherwise it was taking a much longer time. So, thank you.
Now a short video will be played on the process of affiliation.
General information, UDISE code NOC.
further the process, formation of IC, conduct of physical inspection, IC report submission to board and school. School will get a recommendation letter. In case the recommendation is not given, a review committee will be formed and process will be revised. Once the recommendation is received, fill Part C of the application and grant letter will be generated.
In Part C of the form, upload the other faculty details and infrastructure details like room size, activity room, playground, indoor games, canteen, clinic, etc. Important location details like nearest nationalized bank, bus station, hospital, metro station, airport, etc. Three report cards will also be generated based on the rubrics.
अभी मैं डॉक्टर प्रज्ञा सिंह जॉइंट सेक्रेटरी एकेडमिक्स से गुजारिश करूंगी कि वो अपना डिटेल्स ऑफ इंस्पेक्शन कमिटी क्रिएशन चेक पॉइंट्स एंड हॉटस्पॉट्स के बारे में योगदान दें।
थैंक यू धान्य मैम। द बोर्ड अपॉइंट्स इंस्पेक्शन कमिटी एज पर द क्लॉज नंबर 10.1.10 ऑफ द सीबीएसई एफिलिएशन बायलॉज 2018। This is done primarily to assess the suitability of school for affiliation and to ensure that the school complies with the mandatory conditions as given under the affiliation bylaws. Inspection committee is formed from a panel of experts and generally comprises two members, one of them is academician. Once nominated, the inspection committee will receive a letter on their registered email ID. The letter has details of the school, mode of inspection and three tentative dates. Inspection can be done on any one of the dates given. The date of inspection shall be after 7 days from the issue of letter, but within the span of next 15 days. IC must follow the code of conduct given. Also, the school will submit a feedback, that is an online feedback, on the inspection committee and the process of inspection. We shall now play a video that will present the details about the preparatory steps schools need to focus upon and to ensure completion before the inspection, which means you must ensure the completion of the requirements given on the day of inspection. All the details which we have mentioned today are available in this handbook, which is uploaded on the CBSE website.
Greetings. The following presentation shall give a description of the preparatory steps to be taken by the schools before the inspection for the new affiliation process laid down by the Central Board of Secondary Education. CBSE has been supporting and collaborating with schools to create a robust education system. Therefore, in tune to the mandate of the National Education Policy 2020, CBSE has taken proactive measures to ensure that the new affiliation process is transparent, completely online, more accountable, and reduces compliance burden, facilitating ease of doing business by a time-bound disposal of affiliation process. With these objectives, the board has empaneled well-experienced and professional inspection committee members across the country to assess the suitability of the schools for affiliation. The school inspection will focus its attention on aspects such as academic process and social development of students, the quality of teaching, the assessment of learning, the physical resources available, students' safety and health, and the quality of leadership help to improve learning outcomes. In this module, we are covering various aspects that the school should focus before the actual conduct of the inspection of the school. As per the re-engineering affiliation process, the various categories of application has been grouped into three groups as follows: Group A, Group B, and Group C. Group A. In this group, 100% inspection will be done by the inspection committee constituted by the board at site, that is, physical inspection. It consists of approval for middle school syllabus, fresh affiliation up to secondary level switchover from other boards, fresh affiliation up to senior secondary level switchover from other boards, and permission of site shifting. Group B. In this selective 3% to 5% cases, the inspection to be done by the inspection committees. It consists of upgradation to secondary level, upgradation to senior secondary level, extension of affiliation, permission of two ships and section increase. Group C. In this group, the school may be granted permission based on the information or data and the documents submitted without inspection. It consists of introduction of additional subject, permission of name change of school, society, trust or company, transfer of school from one society, trust or company to another. The following preparations are to be done by the schools before the inspection. General points on preparation. On successful submission of the application for affiliation and further computerized or AI or machine-based reading and analysis of application submitted by the schools vis-a-vis affiliation norm inspection committee will be constituted by the board. The inspection committee letter will contain the details of the school to be inspected, the mode of inspection and three tentative dates for conducting the inspection. The school is expected to contact the members of the inspection committee and mutually decide any one of the dates for conduct of inspection. In case the inspection committee is ready but the school fails to get the inspection done on any mutually agreed date, except for the reasons beyond control, the school shall be penalized with a monetary penalty of ₹25,000 on each occasion. Further provided that after two such occasions, the case will be rejected on the third occasion. The school is required to ensure that they develop and maintain operational school website with vital information and norms. The requirement of documents in original. The school is required to keep the original copies of the following documents available for verification of the inspection committee. No objection certificate to the effect that state government has no objection to the affiliation of the school with CBSE. Not required for the schools already affiliated. Recognition certificate from concerned state education department as per extant rules and provisions contained in RTE Act 2009. Registration of society, trust or company running the school. Registered land documents as per norms of affiliation bylaws. Land certificate as per the Appendix 10 of the affiliation bylaws. The competent authority to issue the land certificate is DM, ADM, SDM, Tehsildar, Naib Tehsildar, Registrar, Sub-Registrar or any other equivalent land authority. Fire safety certificate to be issued by the fire safety department of the state government or the competent government authority with validity. Valid as on date of final submission of application. The building safety certificate to be issued by competent government authority or the empaneled engineers authorized to issue such certificates by the appropriate government. For example, empaneled engineer of municipal corporations, development authorities, PWD, road and building departments, etc. Any other permission from concerned state education department required as applicable. For example, permission from State Education Department for site shifting, change of name of school or society or trust or company running two shifts, etc. Details of the enrollment of students in each section, staff statement along with the teacher's qualifications, staff salary statement, etc. Records maintained by the school, example, books of accounts, service books, stock register, practical files, attendance register, records of committee meetings, etc. Mandatory public disclosure as per the Appendix 9 of the affiliation bylaws uploaded on the school's website. A system-generated self-certification or DEO certificate uploaded by the school along with its application for affiliation. The facilities or areas in the school campus to be earmarked for inspection. The school is required to keep intact and earmark the following facilities or areas in the school campus to facilitate smooth conduct of inspection by the committee. Sufficient classrooms, occupied and vacant classrooms. Well-equipped laboratories, composite science lab, mathematics lab, computer science lab, and physics lab, chemistry lab, biology lab, in case of senior secondary level, with infrastructure facilities for conduct of practical and other safety arrangement for the safety of the students. A library duly equipped with reading room facilities. A pakka concrete boundary wall or wall with iron grilled fencing with appropriate height of 6 to 8 feet. Parking area and other open area including assembly area. Furthermore, outdoor facilities of at least 200 meter athletics track, facilities for kabaddi, kho-kho, volleyball, basketball, etc. Other rooms such as indoor games facility, auditorium, activity rooms, wellness rooms, etc., along with the faculty interaction or classroom interaction. Adequate toilet facilities along with the sanitary and hygienic conditions in the toilets. Adequate drinking water arrangements and proper installation of fire safety equipment and CCTV camera for surveillance. The details of aspects to be covered in videography. The school is required to hire a videographer in case of physical inspection. The entire process of inspection will be videographed and a clip covering following infrastructure to be uploaded on YouTube. The building, including all labs, library, classrooms, and other facilities. Games and sports facilities. The process of teaching learning in a few classes. Group photo of staff. Toilet facilities available in the school for boys and girls and urinal station in school toilets with proper partition. Aerial view of the school covering school campus, playground, boundary wall all around the school campus. Morning assembly activities. This should be of not more than 1 minute. Additional requirement for virtual inspection. In case of a virtual inspection, the availability of good quality smartphone or tab or iPad or laptop with high-speed Wi-Fi internet connectivity such as 4G data card or dongle. The school should also keep ready alternate backup arrangement of internet such as extra dongle of different internet service provider ISP or scanner and laptop should also be available for scanning of any required documents. The major focus points. The school is required to ensure that the school should possess valid recognition certificate issued by the State Education Department, Fire Safety Certificate and Building Safety Certificate. In case of lease or sublease, the lease deed or the sublease deed of the land or the building should be duly registered before the concerned registration authority of the state and should be for a minimum effective term of 15 years. And lease document should be valid by more than 5 years on the date of the final submission of application. The school is required to ensure that the mandatory public disclosure as per the Appendix 9 of the affiliation bylaws has been uploaded on the school's website. The school is required to ensure no other institution apart from the school is allowed to run or operate in the claimed land area of the school. Furthermore, the school is required to ensure no public road, canal or thoroughfare, high tension line, etc. to be passed through the land of the school. The school is required to ensure that the member of the school management committee should be available for interaction with the inspection committee members. The school is also required to ensure that the teachers, including PTI, librarian, special educator, wellness teacher, should be available for interaction with the inspection committee members. Thank you.
Mr. Piyush Sharma, Joint Secretary, Affiliation, to give the vote of thanks.
Thank you, Dhanini ma'am. I deem it a great honor to propose the vote of thanks on this special occasion. First and foremost, I thank our Honorable Chairman CBSE, Shri Manoj Ahuja ji, who despite his busy schedule has found time to grace the occasion and honor this event with his inspirational words. I also express my heartfelt thanks to our Secretary CBSE, Shri Anurag Tripathi ji, and our Director IT and Projects, Dr. Antriksh Johri ji, for their enlightening sessions. I also thank our other heads of departments as well as our CBSE school principals for their valuable suggestions and inputs for the development of SARAS. My personal thanks to Dr. Pragya Singh, Joint Secretary Academics, Mrs. Dharani Arun, Joint Secretary Affiliation, Shri Vijay Yadav, Deputy Secretary Affiliation, and all my colleagues of Affiliation Unit for their untiring efforts for the success of this event. I'm sure that these changes in the process are user-friendly and meet the needs of schools across the country and abroad, and make it vibrant through data-driven and tech-enabled future. Your feedback will definitely help us to move forward on the path of reforms and achieve the aims of new educational policy. In case of any inquiries, the schools may contact the board on the email IDs and the phone numbers being circulated on CBSE website. Once again, thank you all.